Welcome back. I'm Chrissy Giesenhood, and this is Cup of Sunshine, your Friday podcast brought to you by the Phoenix Center team of the Deutsche Internationale Schule Johannesburg. Lockdown has resulted in a rise in online time, where technology is not only used for e-learning, but excessively for gaming and or social media time. Today, I will be looking at gaming and internet addiction disorder and share some useful tips on how to break the cycle of addiction. Gaming disorder can be experienced across all ages, children, teenagers, and adults. The condition isn't defined by gaming too much or the number of hours played, but rather when gaming interferes with a person's daily life. To be diagnosed, a person must demonstrate all three of the following symptoms for at least 12 months: losing control over gaming, prioritizing gaming to the extent that it takes precedence over other activities and interests, continuing to game despite negative effects on work, school, family life, health, hygiene, relationships, and finances. Internet addiction disorder is focused on compulsion with the internet. Excessive social networking, playing games online, compulsive watching of online videos, excessive blogging, compulsive online gambling and shopping all fall under this. As with gaming disorder, internet addiction disorder interferes with a person's daily life activities such as relationships, work, and/or school. So why is gaming addiction and internet addiction disorder problematic? Brain scans reveal that a gaming and or internet addiction can have negative effects on parts of the brain responsible for emotional processing, executive attention, decision-making, cognitive control, associative learning, and sleep. Powerful neurochemicals such as dopamine, responsible for feelings of satisfaction, pleasure, and euphoria, are involved in maintaining the addiction cycle. The following signs can point towards the development of a gaming or internet addiction disorder in children or teenagers: obsession with the internet, continuously talking about themes related to favorite websites or games, sneaking online when adults aren't watching and checking up favorite sites, games first thing in the morning, throughout the day, and last thing before bed, staying up during the night to be on the web, disobeying rules set in relation to internet time limits, covering up or lying about the amount of time spent on internet, displaying noticeable guilt or defensiveness about how much time is spent online, and losing track of time whilst online. Emotional fallouts include displaying heightened feelings of anxiety, depression, or irritability when access to smartphone, tablets, or laptops are taken away, using the internet, games, and or social media excessively as a crutch to escape from negative emotions such as loneliness, boredom, not fitting in, anxiety, and or depression, becoming disinterested in pastime activities previously enjoyed and choosing to spend time on the internet rather than with family, friends, sports, and hobbies. Scholastic fallouts might include dropping grades, missing assignments, becoming disengaged from class activities, and sleeping in class. Physical fallouts become evident through disregard for personal hygiene. Physical symptoms such as carpal tunnel syndrome, headaches, back or neck aches, unexplained weight gain or loss, dry eyes, and sleep disturbances may also occur. So what can be done to try and break the cycle of gaming and internet addiction disorder? Talk to your children about what they enjoy and why they game and why they want to be on the internet. Their answers will help you identify if there are any other issues that they may be experiencing and use gaming as an escape. Learn how much time your child spends on social media and what they are viewing and or posting. Gaming surveys and internet addiction surveys are useful tools and are readily available on the internet. Educate children that nothing online is secret. Encourage sport and physical activity. This can increase blood levels of serotonin and have a positive effect on mood. Go outside. Putting the phone down and taking a walk outdoors increases your endorphins and provides that feeling of happiness in your brain, boosting your mood and improving your physical health. Install parental control apps, as these can restrict access to certain websites, set time limits, and give an activity log as to how much time is spent on various apps. Create a phone-free, electronic-free zone, for example, at the dinner table. Charge phones in the kitchen overnight. Remove laptops and TVs from bedrooms so that children don't have access to them and can enjoy a full night's sleep. When children are called off their game or internet, ensure that they have an activity to shift to, such as a family outing, a game, or a dinner. This will create a reason to get off. When calling children off a game or the internet, give them time to finish the game. Continuously being asked to get off mid-game can be frustrating and lead to arguments. Ask children how much longer they will need to finish the game and then ensure they get off when the game is over. Set clear rules and stick to them. Schoolwork and homework should come first before any other additional screen time is allowed. Be realistic. Set attainable goals. Recommended screen time for children 2 to 12 years of age is 1 hour a day and 2 hours a day for teens and adults. This stands in huge contrast to the 4 to 7.5 hours that are currently spent on average by most children and teenagers online. So instead of jumping right to the recommended internet usage time a day, start by reducing screen time by 1/2 hour a day each week until the desired time is reached. Professional treatment in form of individual therapy, group therapy, or family therapy, cognitive behavioral therapy, or solution-focused therapy may be needed to stop gaming addiction or internet addiction. As with any concerns that you may have regarding your child, the Phoenix Center team is happy to consult with you and give you advice. That's all for today. I hope you'll join us next week for more helpful hints and tips for managing life during the times of COVID-19.